France. And
what shapes up as the most appealing matchup, Evander Holyfield against Henry Tillman for the WBA Junior Heavyweight Championship on ABC's Wide World of Sports.
Valentine's Day to each and every one of you, and a special big red one to a little boxing history today.
We will, Frank, and in addition to being teammates, they were also roommates at the Pan American Games in 1983 in Caracas. They roomed together in Los Angeles in 1984. Holyfield was involved in that very controversial bout where he wound up having to settle for the bronze medal in the light heavyweight division. Tillman, meanwhile, was one of nine Americans who won gold. He was the gold medalist in the heavyweight division. And as I turn now to Alex Wallow, the irony here is that there were nine gold medalists, one silver medalist, and one bronze medalist for the U.S. at Los Angeles, and the man who won the bronze wound up winning the first title, Holyfield.
That's right, Alan. Anyone who saw the class and the quiet dignity with which Evander Holyfield accepted that controversial disqualification in the Olympics can only be happy for him that he has now finally won a world championship. But even though he is champion, I think he has not yet reached his full potential. This is only his 14th professional fight. And with more experience, he will get better, especially if he gets that surge of confidence that comes to so many fighters when they win a title. As for his opponent today, Henry Tillman, he also is improving. Even though he was the oldest member of the U.S. Olympic team, he was the least experienced in terms of fights in the ring. So two good young fighters getting better with each fight.
Well, Holyfield, like several of his teammates, turned pro in November of 84, the night of gold in New York. Took less than 2 years to win a title, and he won that championship in Atlanta in July. Holyfield was seeking the junior heavyweight championship in only his 12th professional fight and tried to take advantage of the fact he was 10 years younger than the champ by dictating a fast early pace. Evander was sharp through the first three rounds but was hurt by a cowie left in the fourth round, and here in round five, the more experienced champion had begun to assert himself and take control of the fight. But Holyfield was able to weather the storm and began to reassert himself as the fight moved along, and as exhibited by this flurry in round 13, finished with a flourish. The fight was action-packed, went the distance, and Holyfield awaited the verdict.
Quintana scores the fight 147-138 for the winner. And new
months later, Evander talks about life as the champ.
Well, the changes in my life have come. You know, people have recognized me more now since I won the champion, and that being the champion, I feel like I have to act more of a champion and really work harder than I worked to become the champion.
His wife of 2 years, Paulette, views the preceding 7 months this way.
Well, since he became champion, he's at home more. It was when he first started his professional career, he would leave every other month to go into training and he would have a fight. But now, since he has became the champion, it's basically every 3 months or so like that. So we have a chance to spend more time with the kids, and we have a chance to be together more and do things that we used to do a lot before we got married and had kids, you know, go to movies and bowling and things like that.
Winning the title has made me to realize that not winning the gold medal wasn't as bad as it seemed to me. It gave me more inspiration, gave me more to shoot for, and with God in my life, it made a big stepping stone that even though I didn't get the gold, that I kept the faith and kept striving for what was best for me.
And so Holyfield will put his unbeaten mark on the line against this man, the challenger, Henry Tillman. We'll preview him when we come back. As I mentioned, Evander Holyfield has been boxing since he was 8. Henry Tillman, Alex, started fighting only 5 years ago. And 5 years ago, stepping into a ring in quest of a championship had to be the furthest thing from his mind. But here he is.
5 years ago, Henry Tillman was in custody at the California Youth Authority. And when he was in there, he met a man named Mercer Smith, a counselor and a boxing instructor, that man right there in the center of your screen. And Mercer Smith and Henry Tillman went into the ring for the first time in 1982, and just 2 years later, he was center stage before his hometown fans at the Olympic Games. With that rally, Henry Tillman won the biggest prize in amateur boxing, an Olympic gold medal. But Henry had an equally unforgettable moment a few days earlier at the opening ceremonies when the Olympic torch entered the L.A. Coliseum carried by Gina Hemphill, the granddaughter of the great Jesse Owens. Among the athletes who spilled onto the track was Henry Tillman.
I had my camera running back, was taking pictures. That was the first time I ever saw Gina. And I told her that story, and she cracks up about it. And I told her, when I was looking through the lens of that camera, I said, I have to have her. I'm going to get this girl.
They met in the Olympic Village, began dating after the games, and as Henry trained for his pro boxing career in the mountains outside Los Angeles, his thoughts often were on Gina Hemphill, who had returned to her hometown of Chicago to work as a production assistant on the Oprah Winfrey Show. Despite the distance, the relationship grew steadily closer.
Once I started spending a little time with him and everything, he was very funny, and he was always very kind and very charming to everybody. And so many times, fighters are stereotyped as not being, you know, whatever, however they're stereotyped, and he was not that person.
I've become, in my point of view, very successful, you know, in life so far, and I'm not through yet. And I just want someone to share with now.
Recently, Henry fulfilled the promise he had made to himself that day in Los Angeles when he and Gina announced their engagement to be married in July.
Behind every great man is a great woman. And in my eyes, she's a great woman.
Boxing takes a lot of heart. And he's got a lot of heart. He's got a lot of drive. He's got, it also takes a lot of character. And I think that he's got a lot of character.
There's a glow, a warmth, a kind of mellowness, a charm that did not exist prior to the engagement. And all of us thank Henry from the bottom of our hearts for this engagement. It's made a new woman out of all of us. Thank you, Henry!
And so Henry Tillman has a lot to look forward to in his life outside the ring. In terms of his pro boxing career, it is perhaps more important than his Olympic gold medal that Henry Tillman is the last person to beat the hottest boxer in the world, WBC heavyweight champion Mike Tyson. And he did it not once, but twice. As amateurs in the U.S. Olympic trials, and then in the Olympic box-offs. And both times, Henry used his jab and his movement and his overall boxing ability to avoid the Tyson power and win both decisions. He turned pro later that year, and his most impressive win as a pro came in this first-round knockout of Bash Ali that earned Henry the North American Boxing Federation cruiserweight title. In his next fight, he got carried away with his punching ability, forgot his boxing skills, and paid for it as Bert Cooper dropped him twice in the second round. Henry came back strong but lost a narrow decision. He says he learned a valuable lesson in that fight and moved back into title contention with four straight victories, including this knockout win over Cedric Parsons.
There it is, a preview look at the two men as we get set for what we feel will be one of the more compelling matchups of the winter. Evander Holyfield and Henry Tillman, the WBA...
Physical condition of WBA World Welterweight Champion Mark Breland, who was with us here in the studio last week. Yesterday in New York, Mark had surgery on his damaged left hand. We spoke with him earlier, and he's doing fine. Now for today's fight, we go to Reno, Nevada, and Al Michaels. Al?
All right, Frank, we are set. This is the WBA Junior Heavyweight Championship. Two Olympic teammates, two great friends. There's the tail of the tape. Tillman 2 years older and an inch taller. The limit is 190 pounds. And Tillman coming in at 189 and Holyfield 188 and a half. And just about the same reach. And the two of them, two Olympic teammates, meeting for a world championship for the first time in boxing history. And they are good friends, as Carlos Padilla issues the instructions.
Don't throw any punches during the break. Is that understood? That understood? Who's the Chief Second?
I am.
Okay, Chief Seconds will be responsible for any misbehavior of assistant seconds. Make sure that your corner is clean and dry. Is that clear?
Seconds,
come on.
Excuse me.
What's wrong?
Just want to make sure. I want to make sure. No, keep quiet.
Don't
you put your
finger down.
No, 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 no to referee this 15-rounder for the WBA championship, Henry Tillman, who is quick, who likes to stick and move, though he did try to mix it up last July with Bert Cooper and wound up going down twice in the second round and eventually lost the decision. And going down to Bert Cooper is nothing new. That happened earlier today in Canada when Cooper took out Willie DeWitt in the second round.
Coming into this fight, I think Henry Tillman's game plan has to be to use his superior speed and movement, stay away from Holyfield's power. Evander wants to put pressure on. He's going to back Henry up constantly. Good right hand there by both men. Put pressure on and hope to use a superior power and a superior stamina to perhaps stop Henry in the late rounds. I think it's entirely possible, Al, that Henry Tillman will get off to an early lead in this. The big question is, will he be able to last the 15-round distance?
Holyfield proving that he can last the distance and excel at the distance in the 15-round decision in the quick-paced fight with Cowie. Though he did pay the price later, he lost 15 pounds during that fight and was subsequently hospitalized. Holyfield in the white trunks, Tillman in the silver. Holyfield unbeaten at 13-0, Tillman 14-1, the one loss to Bert Cooper in July.
Henry Tillman's making a big mistake right now, Al. He's giving ground, he's moving, but he's just stopping and then not letting his hands go. He has to punch. There's a good right hand.
And he's able to get off the ropes, and he can get himself into trouble when he is against the ropes, but he was able to move out that time.
Good body punch. Blocked in the camera angle, but you heard that body punch by Evander Holyfield. And that also will take away the movement from Henry Tillman as the fight goes along.
A minute to go in the first round, scheduled for 15 at Bally's Grand Hotel in Reno, Nevada.
Really, the thing to watch for in this fight is what happens when Henry Tillman stops. Who gets the better of it when he plants his feet? There, he's planted his feet, got up a good jab, and now...
Good right.
Caught Evander coming in, exactly.
Good right hand by Tillman.
Tillman mixing it up. Moving, then planting himself, sometimes wanting to fight on the inside, sometimes tying up Evander on the inside.
Holyfield missing with his left hand. These two teammates, roommates at the LA Olympics, good buddies, and thus not much pre-fight hype. And they talk about fighting a pound.
I felt like I didn't really want to fight him, but I feel like I've been the best that I want to be, that you're going to run into good fighters that you had shared time and spend time with.
We've always been good friends and held respect for one another as just people, as just a person, you know.
Both of us would go out and box and do the best we can and do it in an honest way and show good sportsmanship in a way of doing it.
I'm going to get in the ring and do what I have to do to come out the winner. And just hopefully that we're still friends no matter what the outcome is after the fight.
Crowd of between 4,000 and 5,000, and number 24, Willie Mays, looking on today in Reno as we go to the second round of the scheduled 15. In the silver trunks, Henry Tillman, who won the heavyweight title at the LA Olympics, and Evander Holyfield in the white trunks, the silver medalist, or the bronze medalist actually, in the light heavyweight class. Goes down early here in the second round.
Henry Tillman make the big mistake. That is his warrior's heart. He has the heart of a warrior, but not the chin of one. He should be staying out of trouble and grabbing, not trading punches on the inside.
Now he's trying to grab. This thing with a wild right, trying to hold on, trying to tie him up. Holyfield with a right. And trying to work on the body.
Yeah, he's working a little bit below the belt there a couple of times. No warning from referee Padilla. Henry Tillman is letting Evander get punches off. He should be tying him up or moving out of danger.
Holyfield trying to do damage underneath. A minute and a half remaining in round two.
Holyfield in his 13 pro fights to date has been an excellent finisher. He's kept his cool, he's kept his poise, he's stayed relaxed. He's landing some punches here, but he has not landed the finishing punch yet.
And Tillman against the ropes and working his way off and staggering through this second round. Very reminiscent of the Cooper confrontation. Again, he was down in that fight twice in the second round, but came back and in fact may have been ahead going into the last couple of rounds when Cooper came on again to win the decision.
Tillman's hurt again. His legs are all wobbly.
Holyfield chasing him across the ring. Very rubbery legged right now. 30 seconds to go here in the second round.
And especially body punches, I just don't think that he'll have the movement to survive the distance. Good right hand by Henry Tillman.
Out of nowhere. But in all, a big, big round for the champion, Evander Holyfield. Round three, Reno, Nevada. Evander Holyfield defending his WBA Junior Heavyweight Championship. He had Henry Tillman on the deck in round two. A big round for Holyfield after a spirited first round. Round three now, and this one's scheduled for 15.
It looks like the punch that floored Henry was an overhand right that caught him on the temple, and a lot of times the temple shot will take away the man's legs. We saw that when Mike Tyson stopped Trevor Burdick.
Crowd chanting Holyfield as Pullman tries to bore in.
Because he may not have the legs to move out of danger, but he just can't win a trading war with Evander Holyfield. Evander has superior combinations, superior power, and a superior chin. See three jabs from Evander. Luduva trying very hard, a little bit George Benton, to work that into Evander's repertoire as a part of his weaponry, but he really doesn't use it very often, especially when he's a man hurt. He throws power punches. Holyfield totally dominant on the inside, Al, with hooks and uppercuts.
Using that left hand.
At this point in the fight, Henry Tillman's only hope, as he, in desperation, goes left-handed for one weak right jab, his only hope is that Evander Holyfield runs out of gas.
And that's not likely in light of what we saw in the Kawi fight last July. Another good left hand by Holyfield, and another good round for Evander Holyfield.
Henry Tillman is still hurt. He has never fully recovered from that first knockdown, Al.
Slightly less rubbery-legged here in round three, but still a little glassy-eyed. As we come down to the end 3. A good beginning for Evander Holyfield as he tries to stay unbeaten and tries to remain the WBA champion. Evander Holyfield, a man who's fought only 3 rounds over the previous 8 months. He beat Cowie, and then he took care of Michael Brothers in a non-title fight in Paris on December 8th. Took care of him in round 3. So only once in 8 months, but looking very fresh, looking very sharp, and dominating the early going in this fight with Henry Tillman.
If Tillman is just worn down, it just looks at this point like if Evander takes his time, works especially to the body, that it is just a matter of time before he stops Henry. He has not gotten a second, Henry Tillman has not gotten a second win, and it doesn't look like Evander is tiring out. Devastating on the inside.
Lou Duva in Holyfield's corner. He's watched Evander emerge to the point he's a very skilled and a very accomplished boxer, very determined, quietly confident.
I think that Evander Holyfield caught a punch there in that exchange. He's fighting back now with a good right hand.
And Tillman unloading with everything as Holyfield has to tie him up.
The body, Evander. The body. Go to the body.
Evander Holyfield told us he was caught by a good left hook from Dwight Muhammad Cowie when he won the title in the fourth round.
And this is round 4. And that's when Cowie started to take control of that fight, but eventually Holyfield with a second win came back, finished with a flourish, and won a split decision. For our local stations along the line, we'll take a station break at the end of this round. Round 4, Reno, Nevada, Evander Holyfield. Good combination against Henry Tillman. Tillman's been down once. He went down for the mandatory 8 in the second round and in trouble here in the fourth.
And Henry Tillman must be very, very discouraged. He hit Evander Holyfield with the best punch he has and put a series of punches after it. And here he is right back in his face.
Versus Smith, the man who worked with, weaned Tillman, his trainer.
Tremendous amount of punches.
We'll return with more of ABC's Wide World of Sports 15-round junior heavyweight bout between Evander Holyfield and Henry Tillman after this from our local stations. Round 5, it's scheduled for 15. Evander Holyfield, the WBA junior heavyweight champion, and Henry Tillman, his Olympic teammate. Tillman, the challenger, scheduled for 15. There's been one knockdown thus far as Tillman went down in the second round. Holyfield took Tillman's best shot in round 4 and then recovered and finished spiritedly in the second half of the round. Carlos Padilla, the referee.
Again, Henry Tillman trying to work on the inside. You saw there 3 straight, 4 punches missed. His skills are essentially those of a boxer from the outside. Haven't seen his jab, and really haven't seen, except for occasional flares, the good straight right hand that he possesses. And in contrast, there was Holyfield on the inside connecting.
Holyfield becoming more and more accomplished and skilled as he goes along. Another good left hand.
Henry Tillman is badly hurt here. It just looks like all Evander has to do is just to put together a series of punches. And when he does, just Henry Tillman's conditioning and heart is keeping him up right now.
But the cumulative effect, very evident, very much taking its toll. Another good right by Holyfield. Again, dominating here in round 5. Tillman appears ready to go again. He's already been down once.
And look at him fight back, Al.
Good right by
Evander Holyfield.
At this point in the fight, he's too brave for his own good. Evander Holyfield temporarily punched out. If Henry Tillman had anything left, he would have jumped on it, but he just doesn't.
Holyfield looking very much the 5-1 favorite. As he again dominates the round. Live Reno, Nevada, Al Michaels with Alex Wallow, the WBA Junior Heavyweight Championship. On the left, in the white trunks, Evander Holyfield. Very sharp today against Henry Tillman, who was down in the second round. You could perhaps make a case for Tillman winning round one, but that would be it. Holyfield has dominated since.
You see Evander starting at this, out this round jabbing. See if he's able to put punches together with the jab. If and when he gets to that stage of his development, he's going to be fearsome. Pretty tough right now.
Oh, yeah. Evander's wife on this Valentine's Day, Paulette. Looking on as her man tries to win his 14th professional fight and retain his WBA Junior Heavyweight Championship. Funny thing, when these two guys turned pro, there was a 33-pound difference. Holyfield made his professional debut at 177. And Tillman made his at 210. And it's one twain that met at about 189.
Part of the backdrop of this fight is that Evander Holyfield.
Whoa! Another good right by Evander. He's got Tillman on the run again.
You saw Evander shake his head. He just couldn't line him up for the punch that he wanted to finish him. But that right hand to the body is just taking the legs completely away from Henry Tillman. And with his legs goes his entire chance to win the fight. Henry tried to snap a couple of jabs, but really nothing on his punches at this point. And he has not shown in his career, as Henry Tillman, an ability to get that second win, to finish strong. After he was knocked down by Cooper, he did come back to win all the middle rounds, but that was more a matter of Cooper running out of gas than Henry getting his second win. And he lost the last round and lost the fight.
And again, if you missed it, Bert Cooper won today, second round TKO in Regina, Saskatchewan, over Willie DeWitt, the man who Henry Tillman defeated for the gold in L.A. in 84 in the heavyweight class. Evander Holyfield, still very much the aggressor, still very much in control of the fight as we come down to the end of round six in Reno, Nevada. Reno, Nevada, we go to round seven in a fight being controlled by Evander Holyfield, the champion, trying to stay unbeaten against Henry Tillman, who's been on the run the last couple of rounds and has already been on the canvas once in round two. Carlos Padilla, the referee. Alex, as I watch Holyfield, and we've watched him since he made his pro debut and before that as an amateur, he may not be what you would call gifted necessarily, but he appears to be highly skilled, more and more skilled as he goes along.
And he's more of a thinking fighter than I think people realize. He really is trying to put things together which you could qualify as being scientific. He tries to parry right hands with his right hand by the side of his head. He tries to put punches together. He said he wanted to get close. Oh, good.
Padilla looks into his eyes.
Padilla was looking for Henry to give him an excuse to stop the fight, but Henry refused to give him that excuse. He told him he was okay. But Carlos Padilla said, look at Henry Tillman.
the second knockdown. The three knockdown rule is in effect. So if he goes down again, if Padilla lets this continue, that would do it. Padilla is going to let him go at it again. And if he goes down once more, that will do it. He's already been down twice in the round, three times in the fight. He's ready to go, and that's it. Evander Holyfield stopping Henry Tilden in the seventh round, knocking him down four times in the fight.
That fight was a perfect example of when a referee should look at a fighter and not listen to him. Henry Tilden said he was all right each time Carlos Padilla asked him, but he should, Carlos Padilla, should have stopped that fight after the second knockdown, Al.
And Evander Holyfield with another very impressive performance. Tillman's best round was the first. You could have scored that one either way. And then after that, no contest. Evander Holyfield, the bronze medalist in 84, but as a pro, 14-0, 10 knockouts now. And we'll go back and take a look at the first of the three knockdowns that ended it here in round seven, Alex.
Holyfield just puts combinations together so well. He just keeps coming after you. You have no place to run and no place to hide. This is the second knockdown. Again, just a series of punches, not one in particular. There, that Henry really put himself down, sat down, and coming up the third knockdown that stopped the fight.
And it's true, there was very little doubt after the second of those knockdowns that the fight could have been stopped. Fortunately, just not much further damage was done. One more punch and down he went, and with a three knockdown rule in effect, that wrote an end to this one in round seven. And we'll return after this commercial and a word from your local station. Officially, the end comes 143, round seven, TKO Evander Holyfield over Henry Tillman, and Evander's with Alex.
Evander, it's Valentine's Day. Henry's your good friend, but as Al Michaels said at the top of the show, there was no love lost in the fight today.
No, it wasn't. Henry came in and fought as a sportsmanship. He's a good fighter, good, strong fighter. I didn't want a lot of good shots. He showed that he had a willing heart to fight back after all them tough shots.
Let's take a look at the knockdowns that led to the end in the final round. I believe we're coming up to the first knockdown here.
Can you see it? Yeah.
Yeah, there was the right hand. Was it easier than you thought, Evander?
Oh, not at all. Not at all. I was basing Henry's fight on his amateur experience. He showed me a lot of different things. And I thought maybe I could put the jab to the body and maybe come up with a right hand. But he moved a lot and had me off balance a lot.
Were you hurt in the fourth round? I thought he caught you with a punch in the fourth round.
No, he didn't hurt me at all. Henry, his punches were glancing, and I was able to slip with the punches as my coach had me doing.
Were you surprised he took so many punches? Do you think he would go down easier than he did? He showed an awful lot of heart.
Yes, I was very surprised. I hit him with a lot of clean shots on the chin, and I hit him with a lot of good uppercut. And I think the basic thing was that he was able to get back and have me off balance a lot. But it's moving back.
Do you think the referee let it go too long? One knockdown too long?
Well, I can't really say that. I wasn't really paying attention to the referee. Henry Zate was able to fight himself back into the fight. So it was better for the referee to let it go because anybody could have said that he really wasn't out yet. But the referee let it go long enough for everybody to realize that he was out.
Ken Sander, Evander's manager, and Lou Duva's co-trainer. Where do we go from here? And is Mike Tyson down the road in the far distance?
Well, I don't think Mike Tyson's out of the realm of really making a hell of a match over here. But right now, Evander's in a position to fight Carlos De Leon, fight Ricky Parkey. He wants to clean up the junior heavyweights first. After that, we'll see if Tyson is still there. Tyson's still there, we might be there too, and we're ready to fight him. I think the logical match would be Michael Spinks. That's the one we'd like to fight.
How do you feel about moving up, Evander?
Well, I feel like when nature takes its toll and my trainers and everything, see him work out with heavy guys and let them be able to dictate where my next move will be.
Congratulations. Let's go back to Al Michaels at ringside.
All right, Alex. So Evander Holyfield, who made his pro debut in 1984, and he took on a pretty good opponent for a guy making his first professional bout. Lionel Byarm was his opponent in Madison Square Garden on the 15th of November, 84. Holyfield won impressively. He has remained unbeaten as a professional at 14-0 with 10 knockouts. Had things very much his way, totally in control today. A 5-1 favorite, and looked very much like a 5-1 favorite, even though this bout figured to be, in the minds of many, those following the sport closely, far more competitive. But it wasn't. Henry Tillman is the loser, and let's go back to Alex.
And a very gutty loser and a gracious loser to come over and talk to us. Henry, it looked like you got hurt in the second round and never really got your legs back after that.
Well, yeah, I got shook in the second round, but I don't think that was the cause of me losing or getting knocked down later in the fight. It's just that one of them things, you know. I have no excuses. This is a better man today, you know.
How important were the body shots that he got on you?
I guess any amount of body shots will do something to you in the later rounds. But I doubt if the fight got that four and eight rounds for the body shots to really mean that much. Just that I stepped back too many times with my hands down, coming out of the clinches or whatever, out of the inside work, and got caught with some of them short hooks stepping out with my right hand low.
You're still relatively inexperienced, Henry. Not as many amateur fights as most people would think to win a gold medal, and certainly very early in your professional career. Where do you go from here? How do you put it back together again?
Well, I don't know right now. It's almost definitely going to be back. I mean, that's not going to stop me from with my further my career. But I'm just going to, I guess, take a little time off and just relax a little and, you know, go over my mistakes here.
Good luck to you, Henry.
Thank you, Alex.
Thanks for stopping by.
No problem.
Back to Al.
All right, Alex, and so at 143 of round 7, Evander Holyfield puts Henry Tillman away with a 3-knockdown rule in effect and remains the WBA junior heavyweight champion. And from Reno, Nevada, at Bally's Grand Hotel, we go back to New York.
Evander Holyfield, who won his title in only his 12th professional fight, off that 15-round decision over Dwight Cowie last July in Holyfield's hometown of Atlanta. One of the stirring fights of the year. Holyfield managing to survive the early barrage and then came on strong to dominate the later rounds, going on to the split decision victory. Ricky Parkey is making his way with his son Toby, who you met earlier, holding the IBF Cruiserweight Championship belt. Ricky Parkey on his way toward the ring out of Morristown, Tennessee, a record of 19-4, 12 by knockout. Won the IBF title last October, stopping Leroy Murphy in the 10th round.